Hello everyone, the topic I'm going to explain to you today is relevant to macroeconomics A2 level, and this is national income equilibrium. And I will be completing all type of economies like 2 sector, 3 sector, 4 sector equilibrium in this video lecture, and I hope all of you will benefit from it. And furthermore, you must know that 2 sector economy is a type of economy in which there are 2 economic agents including households and firms. And 3 sector economy is a type of economy in which there are 3 economic agents including households, firms and the government. And 4 sector economy includes households, firms, government as well as international trade, that is exports minus imports. So I will be explaining national income equilibrium in 2 sector, 3 sector and 4 sector economy one by one. And in 2 sector economy, equilibrium national income takes place at a point where investment is equal to saving. So this is zero and this is negative area and this is positive area of saving and investment. On y axis I am showing saving and investment, and on x I am showing income, national income. So we know that investment into sector is taken as autonomous investment, so investment is I naught. And saving looks like this. This is saving curve which starts from negative region and it is positively sloped. Equilibrium will take place at point A where saving and investment intersect each other. So equilibrium national income will be 5-1 where saving is equal to investment. So this is national income equilibrium in 2 sector economy. And in 3 sector economy we consider 2 methods. One is leakages injection method and the second one is aggregate expenditure method. So starting with aggregate expenditure method, and in case of aggregate expenditure method we use Keynesian 45 degree line, and this is the concept presented by Keynesian school of thought. And as per Keynesian school of thought, aggregate expenditure will be equal to income if we move along 45 degree line. On x we have income and on y we have aggregate expenditure. But in reality, aggregate expenditure curve is not equal to the income all the time. Rather, aggregate expenditure looks like this. And aggregate expenditure in 3 sector economy is equal to C plus I plus G. C stands for consumption, I for investment, G is government expenditure. In 3 sector economy, there are 3 economic agents and they are represented by C, I and G. Equilibrium takes place where aggregate expenditure intersects 45 degree line at point E, and equilibrium national income will be Y1. And this is the area of inflationary gap. This gap is known as inflationary gap because in this case expenditure are more than income. Blue line is expenditure and this green line is income. So expenditure is greater than income. So when aggregate expenditure are higher, they cause demand pull inflation and aggregate demand increases as well as inflationary gap arises. And after point A, this area shows deflationary gap because in this case aggregate expenditure is greater than the income, so it will cause fall in general prices, so deflationary gap will arise. And this deflationary gap can be filled by increasing investment, so deflationary gap is always equal to change in investment. For example, if this much is the deflationary gap, and this gap can only be filled if we increase investment or we increase government expenditure or increase consumption, then this aggregate expenditure curve will shift upward and it will move somewhere at this point, for example, and as a result this deflation gap will be removed. In 4 sector economy, aggregate expenditure curve is let's say this. This is aggregate expenditure which is equal to C plus I plus G. Now since it is 4 sector economy, so we will add X minus M, net exports as well. So now equilibrium will take place at point E where national income equilibrium is Y1. And again this gap is inflationary gap and this gap is deflationary gap. Now coming to leakages injections method, and leakages are basically the ways through which cash leaks from the circular flow of income and withdraws from the circular flow of income. And injections refer to the methods through which cash is injected into the economy or cash enters the circular flow of income. And in this method, leakages injection methods, what we do is we have to draw leakages and injections lines. Injections are investment, government expenditure, and exports. So I plus G plus X shows injections. These are injections, and all of them are autonomous in nature. So that's why injections line is horizontal straight line. And on X we have income, and on Y axis we have leakages and injections. While leakages look like this, this is leakages line, and leakages include saving plus taxes plus imports. If we save money, then income outflows from the circular flow of income. If we pay taxes, it again moves to the government, and if we import it, money moves from the country to another country. So leakages, these are leakages and these are injections, and leakages injections intersect each other at point E, where national income will be equal to Y1, and leakages are equal to injections at this point. So this is the way we find out national income equilibrium in two sector, three sector and four sector economy. If you are interested to know how multiplier effect will cause national income to change, then you are advised to watch the next video as well. So this is it for today, and see you in the next class, inshallah.